Hi, welcome to a KTV5 video tutorial. I want to show you another version of the crankshaft, now in Katia. And I will do it in a similar way as in Invent and SolidWorks. And I will do it in three parts, same procedure as in the other programs. And if you're interested in an older version, which is that crankshaft in one part, it's already in my YouTube channel. And now let's have fun with KTV5. Let's start with a position sketch on the set X plane. Swap those axes and reverse H direction. And hide these. I need two circles, one, two. This diameter should be 80. That one should be 300. This center should be coincident to that axis. This one as well. This distance should be 35, and let's try to make a dimension between that and this, and that should be 167. Now let's add profile. Don't snap on anything. Okay. Add symmetry with a symmetry line. This should be a distance of 150. That's amazing. So let's undo this one. Make this 150. That's really crazy. So make these two symmetric to that axis as well. Make these tangent. The symmetry is already there, so both are tangent, and add an angle of 40 degrees. And this distance should be 150. Now let's trim. Leave that sketch and make a pad with 20 millimeters in Y direction. And I forgot, I need some bodies. One, two, three, four, five. And I will change this one with that one. Change part body, confirm. I want to have an empty part body, and I want to rename those. This should be the counterweight CW. This would be the CRL connecting rod channel. So CRJ, that would be the intermediate main bearing channel, so call it IMBJ. That would be the main bearing channel MBJ, and this last one could be the flange FLA. Okay, now let's switch to the connecting rod channel. I could hide that body, make a sketch on that plane, hide these, and the profile should look something like this. Really seems my mouse is sort of going crazy. I don't want those HV constraints, so I will delete them. First, switch this one to a center line. Yes. Now add some dimensions. This distance would be 5. That one would be 5. These two should be 40 millimeters apart. That distance would be 24, and this distance would be 28. Of course. Now let's take a look. These two should be coincident. Okay, that line should be on that axis, coincident, and this one with that one. Leave that sketch and make a shaft and confirm. Hide this one, but I could use that sketch, so go for the sketch, copy it, paste it into the IMBJ body, and change those values. This should be 38, and this should be 42. Leave that sketch, make another shaft, and confirm. Hide that one. Now make this the active body. Make another sketch on that plane, hide these, and this would look something like this. So I will snap onto that directions, but I will delete them afterwards. Okay. Go to the sketch and delete those parallel constraints. And now add some dimensions, and of course this should be a center line. And if you have a center line, you could diameter dimensions as well. I will do all those dimensions like this and change them with the Edit Multi-Constrain tool. So this would be 5, I know, but go to Edit Multi-Constrain and work them through. That would be 5. Next would be, I think, 55. Next one would be 115. This would be 150. That would be 22. This one would be 30. That one for 38. And the last one, 42. And okay. Now put this line onto that axis, coincident, and that line onto the set axis, coincident. Leave that sketch, make another shaft, and confirm. Hide this one. Now the flange. Again, a sketch on that plane. Confirm, hide. And this sketch would look maybe like this. Change this one to center line. Remove those parallel constraints. If you wonder why, check out my Katirbi 5 Basics video regarding that topic. So this should be 15. Distance should be 25. This one is 30, and that one 55. Put that line onto the y-axis, coincident, and this one onto that axis, coincident. Leave that sketch, make another shaft, and confirm. Let's show those all together. So that would be my base bodies. And I want to copy those bodies into another new part. So let's go for another part. Call this one Katir segment. And it should be a crankshaft segment. Crankshaft segment. And I want to copy these 5 bodies. Control C or just copy, switch to the new part, and right click, make paste special, and really. Go back. I wanted to copy them all together. It seems that's not possible. So let's copy one by one. Copy, switch, we'll tile them vertically, go over here and paste special as result with link first one, then copy this one, copy, paste special as result with link, copy this one, paste special as, nope, I want to copy that MBJ, copy and paste special. So why can't I copy that MBJ? Because there is no shaft right here. So I really forgot to do that shaft. Nice. Or did I? Oh yeah, I did that shaft in the wrong body. So those kind of things happened. So let's copy this one to that one. No, let's delete this one. And that's why I couldn't paste them all together. Okay. And now make this the active body and do a shaft right there with that sketch and confirm. So now this one is sort of not working because I deleted one there. Now I should be able to copy those bodies all together. These four, right click, copy, and paste them special as result with link. So now I got five copies of these bodies, and that just results with link. So I could change the names to CV on the line, C for copy, and so on. It's not necessary, but I need a copy of this one. So I could go for another copy, copy this one, and paste it special over here as result with link. Now let's change the name to CV2 and that one to CV1. Okay, now that's not needed at the moment. Now I want to move those body. I want to move those bodies with the move command, which should be this one, yes, translation. And I want to translate the CV2 body. But see, because it was the active body, it will be translated or transformed. The direction would be the y-axis, and that would be 20 millimeters. Not 20 millimeters, this should be 40 millimeters, 60 millimeters to be precise. Seems I'm kind of tired. Okay, now that should be moved by 20 millimeters, so make it the active body. Go for another transformation, confirm, and this should be along that direction, and it should be 20 millimeters. And it should be translated again. Translation seems a little bit odd, so they should call it transformation. And now that should go in this direction, but 40 millimeters. And now that body is in the right or correct position. So now I want to move the IMBJ, make it active body, go for that transformation, confirm along that axis, and that would be 2 times the counterweight width plus once that length. That should be 20 plus 20 plus 40, that's 80 millimeters. Nice, and the flange should be moved 5 times 120. Along that direction, 5 times 120, enter. Now let's make a new body and make a segment. So go to insert body, and call this one segment. And I want to add the counterweight and the copy of the counterweight, these two, and the connecting rod channel and the intermediate main bearing channel to that body. So select them and add them to the segment and confirm. And now I want to make copies of these bodies and insert them into a new part. So let's go for a new part. Part design, call this one complete crankshaft. Okay. Go to the segment part, Control C for copy, switch to the new part, Control V, it's nonsense, make paste special, of course, as result with link. Now we got those three linked bodies over here. And now I want to have 4 copies of this one. So we'll switch back to the segment and just copy the segment 5 times. Altogether, that means I need 4 more. So copy, switch to that part, paste special as result with link once, twice, 3 times, and 4 times. Now let's move those. Start with that one. Confirm, direction would be that axis, and that would be 120 millimeters. Make that one the active part, sorry, body, and again, that's the axis, and it should be 240. Now, make Let the active body, and again move it along that axis by 360 millimeters, and the last one, move it, yes, by that axis and 480 millimeters. Now let's rotate them. The first one should be not rotated. This one should be rotated by -144, -144. Next one would be the third one. Rotate it around that axis, and this should be -216 degrees. And the fourth one, rotate it by -288 degrees. And the last one should be rotated by -72 degrees. Nice. And now I could add them all together, so make a new body, or I could use the part body. So let's just put them all together into the part body and confirm.